Hey guys, Nathaniel Dodds and TutVid.com. I want to talk today about what I've got in this package. It's the wireless kit for your Wacom tablet. It allows you to take your current existing Wacom tablet, for the most part, some of the Wacom tablets are not compatible, but we're going to check out which ones are. It allows you to take it and convert it to a wireless tablet. So I'm going to put this box somewhere else. So instead of having a 7 foot or longer USB cable to connect your tablet to your computer, you get a wireless transmitter, just as if it's a wireless mouse or a wireless keyboard or whatever. It's pretty cool. It is battery powered. You do still need to use your USB cable to charge the battery that we're going to put into the tablet itself, the Wacom tablet. And I'm using here, it's an Intuos 5. It's the Intuos Pro, and it's the medium size. But these little Wi-Fi transponders, they are compatible with the Intuos Pro, the Intuos 5, the Bamboo Capture, the Bamboo Create, the Intuos Draw, the Intuos Art, Intuos Photo, and Intuos Comic Series tablets. So it's like the same wireless kit that goes for all of the tablets. But let's go ahead and open up the wireless kits. Before we do that, it has up to a 15-hour battery life, although most of the stuff I've seen online says you get more like 6 to 8 hours, depending on the size of the tablet. And it's pretty cool. You can use it up to like 30 feet away from the computer. Let's go ahead and open this thing up. So I'm just going to grab it. I could take out the knife, but you know what? Let's do it the old-fashioned way and just rip this bad boy open. There we go. Nothing else. Step back there. All right, so here it is. Wireless accessory kit right here. Pretty small in a pretty big box. It's like 40 bucks as of right now. I did go ahead and get the knife because there's a little bit of tape here. Just gonna go ahead and cut that open. And let's see what we've got here. Safety first, as long as it doesn't cost anything extra. All right, so what we've got here is the transmitter or something, and then of course the little USB plug that actually will plug into the USB port on your computer or in your USB hub, whatever, and then of course the good old battery, wireless accessory kit, whatever, and also, I threw it on the floor, and then some other stuff. I don't know what that is. I'm assuming one of them is the manual. I threw that on the floor. What the heck. I'll throw it all on the floor. I'll pick it all up later. All right, so that's all it is. You get a battery and the little transmitter stuff. So let's take a look at actually putting this into the tablet. So on the back of the tablet here, we have two different areas. Everything is kind of on the same side of the tablet as the USB plug is. We've got one little area where you can stash the actual USB receiver, then the area where the transmitter goes, and then the battery goes underneath this part of the tablet. So we can open that up, and you can see, pop the battery case off. That's great. And I can pop the other case off, I think. There we go. Cool. Now, for the USB the receiver, that does actually plug into your computer. However, the little door here, you can see it sort of slides open and bends out a little bit. It actually kind of appears to be pretty fragile. It can slide into there, and you can stash it in there. You know, if you're taking this thing on the road, it just gives you a convenient place to store that receiver, so you don't have to either keep it plugged into your laptop or whatever, or in your station if you're, you know, out on set all the time and you have a Wacom tablet set up. So let's go ahead and take the little transmitter and slide that into place here. So we're going to remove the little temporary placeholder. Here's this little thing right here. Great, so get that out of the way. And this thing should just slide right in. It should be pretty seamless. Slides right in, you can see that. It just beautifully lines right up with the edge of the tablet. For the actual receiver, this is gonna plug right into a USB port, so we don't need to plug that into the tablet. And what that means is we can slide this whole thing right back on. There we go. So the back is back in place, and we have just the little, I can flip the tablet over here. We got a little light and telling us our battery, how much battery is charged, and we also have sort of the power on off button, but it's not going to do anything quite yet because we don't have the battery in the tablet. So let's go ahead and stick the battery in place. All right, so battery, simple, line up the three metal things with the three metal things, bada bing. Cool. All right. Slide this baby back on here. Cover up that battery. And let's check this out. I press the button. Maybe press and hold the button. And nothing happens. Why does nothing happen? I'm not sure. Probably because it needs to be plugged in and charged. Ah, yeah. So here we go. It says that after 6 hours, your battery will be fully charged. But after 3 hours, it'll be 85% charged. So what I need to do is I need to take the USB cable and I need to plug it in to my current computer, let this thing charge, and then we'll try to fire it up. All right, and sure enough, here, as soon as we plug it in, you can see that a light does turn on. It's orange or yellow, indicating the fact that the battery's not yet fully charged. When the battery is fully charged, that actually turns the color green. So that's great. So we know this unit is in fact working. So we need to leave this for a few hours, let it charge. Now, one thing that you should think about here is the fact that the battery in this Wacom does only last, like I said, 6 to 8 hours. Wacom says about 15. I think realistically expect more like 6 or 8 hours of life out of it, and you'll need to leave it charged for 3 to 6 hours to recharge it. So if you're doing heavy retouching for 10, 15 hours straight, well, just know you're going to need the USB cable. You'll be able to do wireless retouching for about half the time. You're going to need to plug it in and recharge it at some point halfway along the way or something like that. But that's it. You can see it's super simple. I didn't even read the directions, and the only place we ran into a snag is the fact that it didn't turn on, but hey, it would have just made sense that we would have had to plug it into USB and power it up. But that's going to be it. I have the Wacom tablet already, the Wacom tablet driver already installed on my computer, so it's going to connect just like a wireless mouse would. All I need to do is plug the little receiver into my USB port. It'll be connected, and I can use my tablet now completely wirelessly. More important to me is just it's going to be a cleaner look for my desk. I won't have to have this giant black. It's not really giant. It's just long, and there's no good place to coil it up and wrap it up. And it just sticks right there out of the side of the tablet and runs off your desk, and it's just messy looking. So with the wireless kit, and it was like $40 for the wireless kit, I'll be able to have this completely wirelessly, grab it, use it, and then at night when I'm not doing any retouching or doing anything really, I can just plug it in, let it charge up, and it'll be ready for me the next day when I need to go ahead and retouch. So, for the wireless tablet, the wireless conversion kit, or what does Wacom call it here? The wireless accessory kit for the Wacom tablet. Specifically here the Intuos Pro, but also the Intuos 5 and all the other models of Wacom's tablets that we talked about. That's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodds and TutFit.com. I'll catch you guys in the next one.